Blackstone Publishing presents The Last Coincidence, a Nero Wolfe Mystery by Robert Goldsborough. This book is read by L.J. Ganser.
Chapter 1. Okay, so the Times called it the best Broadway musical of the year. This wasn't the first instance where that esteemed journal and I found ourselves on opposite sides of the fence. I had gone only because Lily Rowan was aching to see the show, and as it turned out, she didn't enjoy it all that much either. The way Lily was acting that night, though, she probably wouldn't have enjoyed Caruso at his peak. She'd been uncharacteristically quiet all through a superb dinner at Rusterman's. We each had the trout Montberry that Nero Wolfe introduced to the menu years ago, when he was overseer of the restaurant following his old friend Marco Vucic's death. And even during what I thought were the show's few good moments, the best she could generate was half-hearted applause or a weak chuckle. She never even gave my ribs a gentle jab with her elbow, which is one of her trademarks when she's having fun at the theater. At the risk of stating the obvious, you're a long way from the vivacious and scintillating companion I have grown to respect, revere, and yea, even adore, I told her in the taxi headed for her apartment on East 63rd just off Park. The response I got was a faint smile. Oh, I know, Archie. I'm out of sorts. I was hoping the show would jolt me out of it. No such luck. Sorry.
Whoa, you don't have to apologize to me, of all people. Think of the many times when I've been preoccupied because of some case the great man and I were buffaloed by. Do you want to talk about it?
She screwed up her face and shrugged. No, I... Oh, why not, for Lord's sake. Come on up for a nightcap. I paid the driver, and we breezed into the lobby of Lily's building, which looks like it was furnished by somebody with a brother who owned a white marble quarry. The hall man, who's been working there for all of 100 years, gave his usual salute and his usual, "Evening, Ms. Rowan. Evening, Mr. Goodwin," making a big flourish out of running over and punching the elevator button for us. A clear-cut example of Lily's lavish Christmas tip paying off. As many times as I've been in Lily's palace, I still find myself gawking like a rube at the artwork and the rest of the decor. Lily Rowan and I are what the gossip columnists would probably term old friends, which is true as far as it goes. The fact is, we are old friends, although that's never stopped either of us from enjoying the company of other members of the opposite sex. If you are looking for any more details about our relationship, you've come to the wrong place. And if you think she'll give you any more details than I will, forget it. Anyway, to get back to Lily. Her late father ventured over from Ireland long before I'd left Ohio in search of fame and fortune in Manhattan. And he quickly got himself involved in both Tammany Hall, that's the old Democratic organization, and the construction business. As I've pieced it together from Lily and from Lon Cohen of the Gazette, Rowan made a mint building sewers in New York. A sizable chunk of that fortune dropped on Lily, who has shown she knows how to use it. A few examples are her weekend hideaway up in Katona, her ranch in Montana, and some pricey pieces of French Impressionist art in her New York apartment. To give you an idea what I mean, before I knew Lily, names like Monet, Renoir, and Cézanne meant about as much to me as Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. One more thing. Despite Lily Rowan's money, however much that is, when she's out with me, I pay. Just so that's on the record. I got myself settled on one of the three white couches in her living room with the scotch and water I'd mixed at the bar in the corner of the room, while Lily sat opposite me, tucked her luscious legs under her, and took a deep breath, contemplating her own scotch. Then she looked up with those dark blue eyes. "Escamillo," she said, using a nickname that dated to when she watched me make the acquaintance of a bull in a pasture. "I need to talk to somebody. You, really. But it means breaking a confidence."
"That's got to be your call, but I think you know that I'm walking around with a lot of secrets that never got any further than here." I tapped the side of my head.
"I know, and I can't tell you why I'm hesitating, except that this involves Noreen."
"Your niece?" Lily nodded, chewing on her lower lip.
"Noreen James is the daughter of..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.